Her friends are planning a candlelight vigil for Demi Cuccia Sunday night at 8 o'clock at the Gateway High School football stadium. They say they had warned her that she was in an abusive relationship, that her boyfriend didn't want her on the cheerleading squad, didn't want her wearing a bikini, and that he was driving a wedge between her and her friends. It appears that when she finally decided she wanted out, it was a fatal decision. When police and paramedics answered the 911 call, they found a 16-year-old girl lying in the street with stab wounds to the chest and neck. The girl, Demi Cuccia, died a short time later. Today, her friends remain stunned.
Yeah, I go through stages, you know, like I believe it and then I don't, and it's just really hard.
She says she'll remember Demi as a person who loved life.
She was a beautiful girl. She loved her friends and her family. She loved to cheer, and she just loved life, and she was so happy.
The suspect in the case, 18-year-old John Mullarkey, was Demi's boyfriend. Some friends say they didn't see aggressive tendencies in him.
To me, he just seemed like a normal kid, active. He's really motivated, actually, like on the soccer field and stuff. Like, I would never see anything like this happen.
Her girlfriends didn't believe he'd be that violent, though they say he tried to control her life.
He was very jealous of her. Like, she wasn't allowed to do anything. If she would come down here, she'd have to lie to him and say she's upstairs in her room. And he would always yell at her and stuff and didn't want her to have friends at all.
Mullarkey is in critical condition in a hospital after allegedly trying to kill himself after stabbing Demi. Police are trying to establish that the motive is what her friends say it was.
That's correct. Why it happened, and you know, obviously, if necessary, again, the county police being the lead on this, if charges will be necessary, to file charges.
Charges would not be necessary if the suspect dies. Again, at last report, he was in critical condition. Now, coming up at 6 o'clock, what lesson her friends say they have learned that every young girl should know. Reporting live in Monroeville, John Greiner, Channel 4 Action News.